क्लासिफिकेशन केवल, सो दिस फाइव किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन वॉज प्रपोज्ड बाय आर एच विटेकर साइंटिस्ट बेस्ड ऑन हाउ मेनी क्राइटेरिया, विच पॉइंट्स ही हैव टुक इनटू कंसीडरेशन टू क्लासिफाई फाइव किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन?
Phylogenetic relationship, mode of nutrition and thallus organization.
Yeah, very good. So, five criteria he took into consideration are, first is mode of nutrition, second is cell structure, third is phylogenetic relationship, then thallus organization, and what is the last one?
Reproduction.
Reproduction. So all these things he has took into the consideration and he has proposed a five kingdom classification. Now let us see what are its five kingdoms. So five kingdoms were, first kingdom was Monera, second kingdom was Protista, third kingdom was Fungi, and fourth kingdom was Plantae, and fifth kingdom was Animalia. Okay, so these are the five kingdoms of Whittaker: Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, Animalia. So now, when you take Monera, in this Monera, unicellular prokaryotes are included. Okay, so in the kingdom Monera, all unicellular prokaryotes are included, and in kingdom Protista, all unicellular eukaryotes are included. Right? So in the kingdom Monera, unicellular prokaryotes are included, and in kingdom Protista, unicellular eukaryotes are included. Now, when you go for plant and animals, I will say you fungi also. When you take plant and animals, these are multicellular. This fungi, it has a unique feature. This fungi is multicellular. It shows some properties of plants. It also shows some properties of animals. Right? So fungi is a class. Fungi is a kingdom which is multicellular. It is saprophytic in nature. Saprophytic means feeding on dead and decaying organisms. It shows some properties of plants. It also shows properties of some animals. So it is included in a separate kingdom, fungi. Now, plants and animals are multicellular, and you know very well what are the major differences between plants and animals. So plants are autotrophic, animals are heterotrophic. So like that, why n number of differences are there between plants and animals. So in systematic way, we will discuss, right? So Whittaker has given five kingdom classification. This five kingdom classification is most accepted classification. This five kingdom classification is a most popular classification. And this five kingdom classification is systematic classification. And this five kingdom classification is based on phylogeny. It means Monerans originated first. After Monerans, Protistans came. After Protistans, fungi came. Then plants came. Then animals came. This is phylogenetic arrangement. First origin, date of birth, January, February, March, April, May. After January, February will come. March will come. April will come, May will come, right? So that is the importance. Whenever we write the sequence, we have to write like this way only, because it is Whittaker's five kingdom classification. He has arranged the kingdoms in phylogenetic order based upon their origin. So Monerans originated first, then Protistans, then fungi, then Plantae, then Animalia. So now in today's session, we will discuss Monera, okay? And after that, Protista, then fungi, then Plantae, then Animalia. Anyhow, animal kingdom we have started and we successfully completed till Porifera. It is another session which is in zoo, so that will be continued. So Monera we will start up today, right? Now let us see what are these actually Monerans.
Sir.
Pavani.
Sir, if an organism shows characteristics of both animals and plants, but it is not saprophytic, will it be included in fungi kingdom?
No, it is included in Protista kingdom, because in Protista, we have two types of protistans, plant-like protist, animal-like protist. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So first one is Monera. So new students, please be active. Please be active in the sense you and बीच बीच में आप जो है बोलते रहो, ठीक है. Kruti, new students, two students are there. One is Sambodhi, another one is एक मिनट में नाम पूछ. याना, याना you are there?
Yes sir.
एक बार थोड़ा और जोर से आवाज करो बेटा.
Yes sir.
Very good, very good. Right. तो बीच बीच में थोड़ा मतलब इंटरेक्ट करो. कहीं भी अगर कुछ समझ में नहीं आता है तो यू कैन आस्क मी. ओके.
हाँ सर.
राइट. क्योंकि डरना मना है.
Yes,
so, Monera, so first Monerans are what? Unicellular prokaryotes. Now I will use little Hindi for your more understanding. So Monerans are unicellular eukaryotes. मतलब क्या हुआ कि जितने भी unicellular मतलब single cell वाले और prokaryotic animals हैं उन्हें मोनेरा किंगडम में डाल दिया गया. प्रोकैरियोटिक मींस व्हाट? इफ द एनिमल सेल्स एज दे आर यूनिसेलुलर, एक ही सेल है और एक सेल, दिस वन सेल, दिस इज अ न्यूक्लियस. इफ देयर इज नो न्यूक्लियस वी से द एनिमल एज प्रोकैरियोटिक एनिमल. ओके, इन सिंपल वर्ड्स प्रोकैरियोट और यूकैरियोटिक में डिफरेंस क्या है? प्रोकैरियोटिक एनिमल में, एनिमल के सेल में न्यूक्लियस नहीं होता है और यूकैरियोटिक एनिमल के सेल में न्यूक्लियस होता है. दिस इज अ सिंपल डिफरेंस. अब बहुत सारे डिफरेंसेस हैं प्रोकैरियोट और यूकैरियोटिक के बीच में, बट द मेन डिफरेंस इज प्रेजेंस एंड एब्सेंस ऑफ न्यूक्लियस. नाउ इन मोनेरा व्हाट आर देयर? इन मोनेरा ऑल यूनिसेलुलर प्रोकैरियोटिक एनिमल्स आर इंक्लूडेड, राइट. नाउ व्हेन यू टेक दिस यूनिसेलुलर प्रोकैरियोटिक एनिमल्स, इफ यू सर्च यू विल गेट द आंसर बैक्टीरिया. ओके, so this unicellular prokaryotic animals, all the if you search for unicellular and prokaryotic animals, they are nothing but bacteria. It means that Monera is a kingdom in which unicellular prokaryotes are included. Monera is a kingdom in which bacteria are present. So bacteria are solo members of the kingdom Monera, because in the nature unicellular prokaryotic animals are only bacteria. That is the reason we say Monera includes bacteria, right? So unicellular prokaryotes are included in Monera. Now bacteria are sole members of Monera. So we have only bacteria in this Monera. Now where do you see these bacteria? Bacteria occur almost everywhere. You can see bacteria everywhere. In the air bacteria is there, in the soil bacteria is there, in the water also bacteria is there. So if you pick up handful of soil in your hands, you can see millions of bacteria in that soil. But we cannot see them with naked eyes. Why? Because they are microscopic. So microscopic organisms needs microscope. So by using microscope only, you can see these microscopic organisms or microorganisms. So these bacteria, they occur in everywhere. They occur in all the places. Okay. Now, some bacteria occur in hot springs, deserts, snow, and deep oceans. These are known as extreme habitats. Extreme habitats means what? Where the situations are very critical. Now where we are living, it is not an extreme habitat, because everything is normal. Temperature is normal, humidity is normal, rainfall is normal. But what is the meaning of extreme habitats? Extreme habitats means critical situation. It may be high temperature, or high acidity, or high salinity. So like that. So now one thing is clear. In Monera, bacteria are the sole members, and bacteria occur almost everywhere, every place. Now some bacteria So they also live in extreme habitats. Like hot springs. So some bacteria can live in hot springs also. Okay, some bacteria, not all. Deserts, some bacteria live in deserts. Some bacteria live on snow in Himalaya regions. And some bacteria live in deep ocean. Deep ocean means inside the oceanic water. Okay, that is a speciality. Now many bacteria live as parasites. Now, can you say what are parasites? What are parasites? What is the meaning of
parasites? Parasites are the organism who live on another organism and unwillingly steal food for them.
Very good. So, parasites are the organisms which will live on other organism and they will cause harm to the organism. Okay, such organisms we are saying it as what? Parasites. So, some bacteria are parasites also. It means they live on other organisms and they will cause damage to the other organisms. Not all, only some. Okay, so some bacteria live as parasites, but many bacteria are parasites. Okay, now this bacteria is classified basically into two groups. Okay, so this bacteria is classified basically into two groups. What are the two groups? Let me say, you know. Now, three things are clear to us. Monera includes unicellular prokaryotic organism, first thing. Monera includes only bacteria, second thing. Monera lives everywhere. Some bacteria live in extreme habitats. Majority of the bacteria are parasites. Majority, not all. Now, this bacteria is classified into two groups. One is known as Arachibacterium. Okay? One bacteria is known as what? Arachibacterium. And another bacteria is Eubacterium. These are the two groups of the bacteria. So, kingdom bacteria or the kingdom Monera. Kingdom Monera, wo kingdom hai sirf, jisme sirf aur sirf bacteria hi hai. Bacteria mein do types hai, do groups hai. Ek hai Arachibacterium, dusra hai Eubacterium. Now, Arachibacteria and Eubacteria are the two categories of the bacteria. Now, first let us see what is this Arachibacteria. This Arachibacteria are ancient bacteria. Most primitive bacteria. Right? These are ancient bacteria. These are most primitive bacteria. So, after Arachibacteria only, Eubacteria formed. So, Arachibacteria are ancient bacteria and they are most primitive bacteria. Now, what is their speciality means? They are special bacteria. Arachibacteria, they are special bacteria because they live in extreme habitats. This is very important one. So what I am saying, Arachibacteria are called as special bacteria. They have a speciality. They can live in extreme habitats. What are extreme habitats? Some of the Arachibacteria can live in high salt concentration. Some Arachibacteria can live in hot springs. Some Arachibacteria prefer to live in marsh places. So that is only the reason we are saying them as a special bacteria. But when you take Eubacteria, they do not have that speciality. If you increase the temperature, the bacteria will die. Our Eubacteria will die. But there are some Arachibacteria which they live in extreme habitats. So that is the reason we are saying them as special bacteria. Okay. Now, the main difference between Arachibacteria and Eubacteria is only the thing. Arachibacteria can live in extreme habitats. new bacteria cannot live in extreme habitats. Clear? This is only the main difference. Okay, so Arachibacteria can live in extreme habitats. New bacteria cannot live in extreme habitats. Now, why? Because the cell wall of Arachibacteria and cell wall of new bacteria both are different. The chemical composition of the cell wall of Arachibacteria is different from the chemical composition of new bacteria. Due to that reason only, Arachibacteria can live in extreme habitats. Okay, so these are the two notable things which are very important. The speciality is that Arachibacteria can live in extreme habitats. Now, these bacteria have different cell wall structure. These bacteria will have what? Different cell wall structure when compared to that of eubacteria. This feature is responsible for their survival in extreme habitats. Now, very simple. Let us think that this is our Arachibacteria A. This is an eubacteria U. Right? Now, what we are saying, Arachibacteria jo hai special bacteria hai, kyun special hai? Kyunki Arachibacteria kahi pe bhi reh sakta, hot pani mein, thande pani mein, garam pani mein, kahi pe bhi reh sakta. Eubacteria ko utni speciality nahi hai. Why the difference comes? Because Arachibacteria ka jo cell wall hai, ये जो अपमान लो ये अपना सेल वॉल है Arachibacteria का. ये जो सेल वॉल है एलएनटी सीमेंट से बना है और इसका सेल वॉल जो है सॉइल से बना है. फॉर एग्जांपल आंसर, ये दीवार जो है सीमेंट से बना है, ये दीवार जो है सॉइल से बना है, तो कौन सा मजबूत होगा ज्यादा? कौन सा मजबूत होगा?
सीमेंट वाला.
सीमेंट वाला,
नो डाउट. सीमेंट वाला, सीमेंट वाला जो है सेल वॉल जो है बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग होगा. उसी प्रकार से Arachibacteria और Eubacteria में क्या मेन डिफरेंस है? Arachibacteria कहीं पे भी एक्सट्रीम कंडीशंस पे भी रह सकता है, Eubacteria नहीं रह सकता है. क्यों नहीं रह सकता? इसका रीजन ये है कि Arachibacteria का जो सेल वॉल है वो कुछ अलग केमिकल से बना हुआ है और Eubacteria का जो सेल वॉल है वो कुछ अलग केमिकल से बना हुआ है. ये केमिकल कंपोजिशन के डिफरेंट के वजह से Arachibacteria को ये स्पेशल फीचर आता है. सी दैट पॉइंट, दिस बैक्टीरिया हैव डिफरेंट सेल वॉल स्ट्रक्चर व्हेन कंपेयर्ड टू दैट ऑफ Eubacteria. दिस फीचर इज रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर देयर सर्वाइवल इन एक्सट्रीम हैबिटेट्स. इसका सेल वॉल अलग रहने के वजह से ही इसको ये स्पेशलिटी मिला है. तरण के कवच कुंडल है ये. अंडरस्टैंडिंग द पॉइंट हियर? नो. तो इसीलिए Arachibacteria जो है कहीं पे भी रह सकता है. ओके, ये पॉइंट क्लियर है आपका?
यस सर.
किसी को कुछ कंफ्यूजन है उस पॉइंट में? कंफ्यूजन, एनी कंफ्यूजन इज देयर इन दैट?
नो सर.
राइट.
नो सर. नो सर.
नो. Now, when you take this Arachibacteria, where they can live, let us see. Now, when you take this Arachibacteria, they live in extreme habitats, we said, I have said you that point. Now, what are that extreme conditions? Let us see. Now, this Arachibacteria A, they are of three types. First type is methanogens Second type is thermo acidophils, and third type is halophiles. Third type is what? Third type is halophiles. Right? So we say that Araceae bacteria is three types. One is methanogen, one is thermoacidophiles, another one is holophiles. Now, these thermoacidophiles are the bacteria which live in hot springs. Right? So, Araceae bacteria, based upon the place where they live, we are classifying them into three types: methanogens, thermoacidophiles, holophiles. Okay? MTH, sambar masala. Right? On which basis we are classifying? On the basis where they live. Okay? Now, Araceae bacteria are of three types. MTH. First, I am saying you what? Thermoacidophiles. What are thermoacidophiles? Thermoacidophiles live in hot springs. You know very well, hot spring in some foreign countries, there are hot springs. Okay? So, these thermoacidophiles will live in hot springs. Example of this thermoacidophile is Thermoplasma bacteria. You remember one example which is not mentioned in NCERT, but you remember one example. If anybody asks you what is thermoacidophile, thermoacidophile is a bacteria which live in hot spring. Thermoacidophile is a bacteria which live in hot spring, and acidophile, acido, acid, acid, acid. Thermoacidophile is a bacteria which live in hot spring, are high acidic conditions. Right? Are high acidic conditions. So, good example is Thermoplasma. What are holophiles? These holophiles live in extreme salt areas. Extreme salty areas where the salt concentration is more. Generally in the ocean, in the seas, how the seawater is? Seawater is salty. So, in that seawater, our holophiles live. Okay? So, holophiles are the bacteria which live in extreme salty areas. There is an example. You remember one example, Holococcus. Holococcus is the bacteria, example of holophile. Okay? So, Araceae bacteria are classified into three types based upon the place where they stay, where they live. One is methanogens, thermoacidophiles, and holophiles. Thermoacidophiles live in hot springs, Thermoplasma is an example. Holophiles live in extreme salty areas, Holococcus is an example. Now what are methanogens? Methanogens live in marshy areas. Now what are the marshy areas? Jahan pe kachra hota hai, jahan pe pure, you can see some areas where the unwanted plants will grow. All the waste materials will be dumped in. That places are known as what? Marshy areas. So, methanogens are the bacteria which will prefer to grow in marshy areas. So, in the marshy areas, when you go, you will get one characteristic smell. Okay. So, if you go to city outskirts, where the municipality will take the all the waste materials from the house, they will dump in some area. If you go to that area, you will get some characteristic smell because there our methanogens will live. Okay. So, methanogens will live in marshy areas. Now, again, some specialties there of methanogens. This you complete. You take screenshot. Now, what is the thing is that methanogens are present. Okay, methanogens are present in the guts of ruminant
leguminous.
You know very well what are ruminant animals. Cows, buffaloes, etc. are ruminants. Many examples are there. Okay. So these methanogens are present in the gut. That means what? Alimentary canal, esophagus, all these are gut only. Okay. We can say the total digestive system. Generally, they are present in the small intestine. So these methanogens are present in guts of ruminant animals, cows and buffaloes. And they are responsible for production of methane. You know very well methane. So ruminant animals will produce methane. Okay. From the dung of these animals. Now, generally, you collect the dung from the ruminant animals. To this dung, if you add methanogens, you will get methane. CH4 is the methane, which is called as biogas. Which is called as what? Biogas. So the methanogens are used in the preparation of the biogas. So one good example of methanogen is Methanococcus. So Methanococcus is a good example of methanogen bacteria. So methanogen bacteria live in marshy areas. They also live in the alimentary canal of ruminant animals. And these methanogens, they will produce methane from the dung of these animals. And methane is used in the used as a biogas. We have LPG gas, which contains mainly butane. We have also biogas. So biogas is also used in many villages nowadays. Okay. So this is the story of what? Arachibacteria. I repeat once again. Arachibacteria. Arachibacteria are ancient bacteria, most primitive bacteria. Arachibacteria can live in extreme habitats because they have different cell wall structure when compared to that of eubacteria. Arachibacteria is of three types based upon the place where they live. MTH, methanogens live in marshy areas, MM. Thermoacidophils live in hot springs, thermo heat. Holophiles will live in salty areas. Halogens, iodine is an halogen. It belongs to halogen family. So salt mein kya hai iodine? Now methanogens live in marshy areas. They also live in the gut of ruminant animals. They produce methane from the dung of these animals. Thermoacidophils live in hot springs. Thermoplasma is an example. Lastly, halophiles live in extremely salty areas. Holobacterium or Holococcus is an example of holophile. So this is Arachibacteria. Now let us see Eubacteria. So if you are clear with Arachibacteria, then I will proceed for Eubacteria.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Everybody is very clear with this Arachibacteria?
Yes, sir.
Right. So can anybody say why Arachibacteria are special?
Because they can live in extreme habitats.
Very good. Because they can live in extreme habitats. Why they can live in extreme habitats?
Because of their cell structure.
Because of their cell structure. Very good. So, because of their cell structure only, they can live in extreme habitats. Very good. So, let us see the next category of the bacteria, Eubacteria. So, in Arachibacteria, we have MTH only. Now, let us go for Eubacteria. Now, actually, the bacterial story starts with Eubacteria only. Because this Eubacteria are the, what you can say, modern bacteria, we can say. Eubacteria. True bacteria. Okay. And we can say that modern bacteria. Eubacteria are modern bacteria. Now study of the bacteria, okay, study of bacteria, we say bacteriology. Remember, study of bacteria, we say it as bacteriology. This bacteria B was discovered by, first of all, bacteria was discovered by a scientist known as Leeuwenhoek. Leeuwenhoek was the scientist who discovered the bacteria. And this Leeuwenhoek scientist has given a name, animal pools. He has not used the word bacteria, but he used the word animal pools for the bacteria. Now this word bacteria was given by a scientist known as Ehrenberg. Ehrenberg was the scientist who has coined the term bacteria. Okay, so eubacteria is true bacteria. It is a modern bacteria. Study of bacteria, we say bacteriology. Bacteria was first discovered by Leeuwenhoek, but he has given the name animal pools. The word bacteria is given by the scientist Ehrenberg. Okay, this is a preliminary information which you have to know, as it is not included in the syllabus or in our NCERT or module. But this is a minimum information which you have to know about the bacteria. Now let us begin the story of eubacteria. One thing we are very vivid that this bacteria, eubacteria or modern bacteria, we are saying them as true bacteria. Now question comes, why we are saying them as true bacteria? Because Arachibacteria was formed at the time of earth formation. Okay, now earth formed, after the formation of earth, after millions of years, life originated on the planet earth. Now there is one theory known as theory of organic evolution. The theory of organic evolution says that life first of all came as unicellular organisms. Life began with a single cell, and that single cell means unicellular, and it was prokaryotic. So that is nothing but that was our Arachibacteria, right? And after the formation of Arachibacteria, at that time conditions were not favorable because there were high hot conditions were there. So after some millions of years of formation of Arachibacteria, eubacteria were formed. And this eubacteria have some advanced features when compared to that of Arachibacteria. So that is the reason we say them as modern bacteria, right? Now why they are true bacteria? Because they will show different features when compared to that of Arachibacteria. So that's why we say true bacteria. Now the bacteria was first of all discovered by Leeuwenhoek. Leeuwenhoek was from a Dutch. He used to play with the lenses. Okay, so you might have studied in 10th class about optics, convex lens, concave lens, all that things you have studied. So now this Leeuwenhoek was the scientist who used to play with the lenses. So eventually, so when he looked some pond water with the lens, he observed some sort of organisms. He was confused in the water, what is this organism? He named them, he said that animal pools. But later on, it was the Louis Pasteur, after the experiments of Louis Pasteur, it was discovered that these are nothing but microorganisms which do not have the nucleus. So Ehrenberg was also a scientist who was given the name, special name, that is bacteria, right? Now let us see about this eubacteria in detail. Now when you go for this eubacteria, this eubacteria may be autotrophic, autotrophic, or they may be heterotrophic. And you know well what is autotrophic nutrition, what is heterotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic means making own food. Heterotrophic means dependent on other animals for food, right? So this eubacteria are autotrophic. And some eubacteria are photoautotrophic. It means some eubacteria can do photosynthesis and make their food. Some eubacteria are chemoautotrophic. It means some of the eubacteria uses some chemical energy to make the food. Photoautotrophic bacteria use solar energy. Photo means light, to make the food. chemoautotrophic bacteria use some chemical energy to make the food, right? So in this eubacteria also we have two categories, autotrophic bacteria, heterotrophic bacteria. Autotrophs are the organisms which can make their own food. Heterotrophs are the organisms which are dependent on others for their food. Now in this autotrophic category we have photoautotrophs, means jo photosynthesis kar sakte hain. Chemoautotrophic jo photosynthesis nahi karenge. In this heterotrophic also we have many categories. Some bacteria live as parasites. They live on other animals, other cells for their food. Some are saprophytes. Some bacteria are saprophytes. They feed on dead and decaying organisms. Some bacteria are symbionts. Clear? Understood? So now, this eubacteria may be autotrophic or heterotrophic. In autotrophic, it may be photoautotrophic, making food with the help of solar energy. It may be chemoautotrophic, making food with the help of chemical energy. It may be heterotrophic. If it is an heterotroph, it may be parasite, dependent on other cell and damaging the cell. Saprophytic, feeding on dead and decaying organisms. Symbionts. You know what is symbiosis?
Mutual.
Yes, sir.
So, in symbiosis, what is the thing? The bacteria live on other cell. It will take food, shelter, and in turn, it is doing some benefit to the other cell. So, that process we are saying it as what? Symbiosis. So, our eubacteria, when you go for their mode of nutrition, they exhibit wide variety of mode of nutrition. Eubacteria may be photoautotrophic, it may be chemoautotrophic, it may be a parasite, it may be a saprophyte, it may be a symbiont. These many varieties you cannot see in RHA bacteria. Understanding the point. So all of these features you can see only in eubacteria. You cannot see all these features in RHA bacteria. Right? So we came to one conclusion. When you take this eubacteria may be photoautotrophic. Some eubacteria may be chemoautotrophic. Some eubacteria may be parasitic. Some eubacteria may be saprophytic. Some eubacteria may be symbiotic. And here we are not interested with the examples. Why? Because this is given in a short in our NCERT and module. So we are not elaborating the examples, ki what are photoautotrophic examples, chemoautotrophic examples, as they are not in our curriculum, right? Now this is the first basic feature of our eubacteria, autotrophic, heterotrophic, all these different varieties. Now second feature, of this eubacteria, are of different shapes. This eubacteria are of different shapes. Now, these are of four types based on shape. Okay, so we classify them into four categories based upon their shape. Right? Now, many students are from CBSE school. So, I'm writing your school board CBSE. Okay? But some students may be, one student, my old student was there. His name was Karthik. He studied 10th class from CBSV, right? So Karthik, jo mera purana student tha, wo kaun se board se padha hai? CBSV. Now, our bacteria are of four types, CBSV, based upon their shape. One is called as foci bacteria. Another one called as bacillus bacteria. Another one called as spiral bacteria. Spirilla bacteria. Another one is Vibrio bacteria. Clear? Now, based upon the shape, bacteria are of four types: foci, bacillus, spirilla, Vibrio. What are foci bacteria? Foci bacteria are spherical in shape. I'm writing spherical in shape. Bacillus bacteria are rod shape. Spirilla bacteria are spiral shape. Vibrio bacteria are comma shaped. Clear? So bacteria based upon their shape are of four types: foci, spherical, bacillus, rod shape, spirilla, spiral shape, vibrio, comma. Right? Clear? Right. Now let us see their diagrams once for more understanding.
Sir.
You are able to see?
Yes, sir.
Spherical, bacillus, like of the rod, spirilla, like spirally coil, vibrio, comma shape. If I say staphylococcus, which shape?
Cocci.
If I say the name staphylococcus, so which shape it will be?
Spherical.
Right. Vibrio cholera.
Comma shape.
Comma shape. Theobacillus.
Rod shape.
Rod shape.
Right. Sometimes what he will do in the NEET examination, he will give the statement Vibrio cholera causes cholera. Right. Listen to the statement. Vibrio cholera causes cholera. Now Vibrio cholera is in which shape? He will give you these four options. So Vibrio cholera is in which shape?
Comma.
Comma. Right. Azospirillum.
Spiral shape.
Spiral shape.
Very good. Very good. So this is only the thing which you also remember. I hope you understood up till this very, very clear.
Yes, sir.
So everything is clinic, all clear. Right?
Yes.
So, new students, you are understanding something?
Yes, sir.
Sambodhi, you are following, no?
Sir.
Sambodhi? Understanding?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Right. No, next thing.
Sir.
What
sir, textbook yes, mein diya hai examples. Bacteria.
No, textbook mein examples nahi diya hai. Okay. Bacteria ka example nahi diya. Wohi, main abhi examples bata diya na. Examples generally NCERT mein nahi hai. Ab jaisa abhi okay ka matlab spherical. Uska example bacteria ka hai. Streptococcus pneumoniae bacteria. Okay, so Theobacillus means rod shaped bacteria, Azospirillum means spiral shaped bacteria, Vibrio cholera, comma shaped bacteria. Okay, now when you go, another thing is that the structure of bacteria is simple, but the behavior of the bacteria is very complex. So when you see the structure, in the next session, you will see the detailed structure of the bacteria. So the structure of the bacteria will be simple. Why? Because it is made up of single cell only. But the behavior of the bacteria is complex. Why? Because some bacteria behaves as a parasite. Some bacteria behave as a symbiont. Some bacteria behave as a saprophyte. Okay. So the bacteria have the simple structure, but they have complex behavior. That is a very important thing. Bacteria have simple structure. but have complex behavior. Okay. Now we have some bacteria which are parasites. Matlab they will cause some diseases. Okay. Some bacteria will cause some diseases. Generally, they will cause cholera. So cholera is a bacterial disease. Many bacterial diseases are there. Mentioned diseases I am mentioning you. One is cholera, typhoid, tetanus. These are the bacterial diseases of human beings. So we will get cholera with the bacteria, typhoid with bacteria only, tetanus with the bacteria only. In the plants, they will cause some diseases like citrus canker. This is a disease name. Okay. Citrus canker is a bacterial disease. And in the same way, blight of rice also they will cause in paddy. Blight of paddy, it is one disease of the paddy plant. Again, they cause crown gall of apple. This is the disease name. We have to remember only the disease names which are mentioned, because he will ask you, crown gall of apple is caused by which organism? He will give you four options there. Bacteria, virus, like that way, he will give you four options. So many bacterial diseases come to humans and also to plants. But the bacterial diseases which are in NCERT, that I am highlighting here. So bacterial diseases coming to the human beings are cholera, typhoid, and tetanus. In the plants, citrus canker, blight of rice, paddy, crown gall of apples. Okay. This you have to remember. Now, I already said you that some bacteria are symbionts. Okay. So, example is with the help of bacteria only we are making curd. They are used in making curd. Okay. Lactobacillus is used generally in making curd. Some bacteria are used for nitrogen fixation. Okay. Some bacteria are used for what? Nitrogen fixation. Some bacteria are used in the preparation of antibiotics. Some bacteria are used for the preparation of antibiotics. Okay. So some bacteria are parasites. Some bacteria are useful to humans also, which are called as symbionts. General uses, they are used for making curd, nitrogen fixation, and preparation of antibiotics. So antibiotics are the drugs which will protect the body from bacterial infections. Okay. Up till this, points are clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, in this bacteria, when you go for reproduction, they undergo asexual reproduction. Most commonly, they will undergo asexual reproduction, right? So, most common type of asexual reproduction is binary fission. Binary fission. It means in this binary fission, the single bacterium will divide into two bacteria. Okay, so binary fission occurs like this way, or it may occur. This is longitudinal binary fission. If it occurs like this way, we say transverse binary fission. Okay, so in bacteria, asexual reproduction is most common, which is binary fission. So during unfavorable conditions, unfavorable conditions means what? When bacteria are facing some natural problems like high temperature, high pH, high salt concentration, that are known as what? Unfavorable conditions for the bacteria. Okay. So during unfavorable conditions, they form spores which are known as endospores. So the bacteria will be forming small spores, which are known as what? Endospores. Right? When the bacteria will form endospores during unfavorable conditions? after unfavorable conditions go, when favorable conditions come, this endospores will form new bacteria. This endospores will form a new bacteria. So now, in the bacteria, reproduction is mostly asexual. Reproduction is mostly asexual and it occurs by binary fission. Now, some bacteria also show sexual reproduction also. Which is primitive type of DNA transfer. It means, remember here, in bacteria, true sexual reproduction will not be there. What is true sexual reproduction? In true sexual reproduction, male and female gametes must fuse, zygote must form, all that things must happen. But in bacteria, true sexual reproduction is not there. Some DNA transfer will take place. Now, what is the meaning of this DNA transfer? For example, this is a bacteria. This is another bacteria. DNA from this bacteria enters into this bacteria. This is known as for DNA transfer. By this DNA transfer process, the bacteria will multiply. They will reproduce sexually. But in pores, to be open, bacteria do not exhibit true sexual reproduction. Most commonly, bacteria will reproduce by asexual method only, that is to say, binary fission. Now, in this sexual reproduction, primitive type of DNA transfer, we are saying, this DNA transfer occurs by three methods. Only the names you have to remember. We must not remember their details. तो डीएनए ट्रांसफर जो है एक बैक्टीरियल सेल से दूसरे बैक्टीरियल सेल्स में होता है. ये तीन टाइप्स का है. एक है कॉन्जुगेशन, दूसरा होता है ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एंड लास्ट इज ट्रांसडक्शन. इन द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी व्हाट आर दिस थ्री मेथड्स, कॉन्जुगेशन, ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एंड ट्रांसडक्शन. ओके. So bacteria, when you speak about the reproduction of the bacteria, reproduction of the bacteria mainly occurs by asexual method. I have already said you what is asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is a reproduction where there is no fusion of gametes. So most commonly, bacteria reproduce by asexual method. But some bacteria may also undergo sexual reproduction. True sexual reproduction is not present in bacteria. DNA transfer, which occurs from one bacterium to another bacterium, these are the two bacteria. DNA from this bacteria transferred to this bacteria is considered as sexual reproduction, but it is not sexual reproduction. I'm adding the point. Transfer of DNA from one bacteria to another bacteria is considered as sexual reproduction. And this DNA transfer occurs by three methods. Conjugation, transformation, transduction. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Meet anything? You have anything to ask me?
No, sir.
Okay. So this is the sexual reproduction of bacteria. Now coming to overall story. Listen once again. Monera, we started. Unicellular prokaryotic animals, organisms are included in Monera. Fortunately, Monera contains only bacteria. Why? Because bacteria are only unicellular and prokaryotic in nature. If any organism is unicellular and prokaryotic in nature, no doubt we can say it as bacteria. So that is the reason bacteria are sole members of Monera. Bacteria are sole members of Monera. Bacteria live almost everywhere. It lives in extreme habitats also, like hot springs, deserts, snow, deep oceans also. This bacteria is categorized into two types, Arachibacteria, Eubacteria, AE. Arachibacteria are primitive bacteria, ancient bacteria. Arachibacteria is a special bacteria because it has a specialty to live in marshy areas, in hot springs, in high salt concentrated areas. So this arachibacteria is of three types based on the place where they live. First, methanogen is a bacteria which lives in marshy areas. Yum yum. They are also present in guts, are the digestive system of ruminant animals like cows, buffalo, sheep, donkey, whatever the ruminant. This bacteria will make methane gas from the dung of these animals. Methane gas is used as biogas. Methanococcus is an example. Then when you go for thermoacidophiles, thermoplasma is an example. They live in hot springs. Holophiles live in salty areas. Holobacterium is an example. Now, after Arachibacteria, we discussed about Eubacteria. Eubacteria are called modern bacteria. They are called true bacteria. First point, we studied about their nutrition. Some Eubacteria are autotrophic, some Eubacteria are heterotrophic. In autotrophic, they may be photoautotrophic, they may be chemoautotrophic. In heterotrophic, they may be parasites, symbionts, or saprophytes. Parasites causing disease, cholera, tetanus, typhoid in humans. Okay. And some plant diseases also they are causing, like crown gall of apple, blight of paddy, etc. Again, we discussed about the shapes. Based upon the shape, they are of four types: CBSV, okay, focus, bacillus, spiral, and vibrio, that is coma shape. Now, when we speak about the reproduction, which is a unique feature, most commonly, Eubacteria reproduce by asexual reproduction, that is to say binary fission. During unfavorable conditions, the bacteria may form some spores, seed-like structures which are called endospores. Sexual reproduction is not there in bacteria, but primitive, matlab DNA transfer from one bacteria to another bacteria is considered as sexual reproduction. And this DNA transfer occurs by three methods: CTT, conjugation, transformation, transduction. Clear? Now, in this Eubacteria, the most common, most popular example of this Eubacteria is, which is studied, is Cyanobacteria. This Cyanobacteria is also called blue-green algae. Okay? Once with. Right? So, related to this Cyanobacteria, in the next class we will do it. Up till then, you can ask your doubts from today's lecture. Kuber, any question from your side related to today's class?
No, sir.
You understood everything?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Which bacteria are modern bacteria? Ishwari, can you say which bacteria are modern bacteria? Sumedh, which bacteria are modern bacteria?
Sir, can I tell? Anand.
Who is saying? Yana, you want to say the answer? Very good.
Eubacteria.
Eubacteria, very good. Eubacteria is a modern bacteria. So, Yajna, why Eubacteria are modern bacteria? Why they are modern bacteria? Who can say this?
Sir, can I tell?
Yeah, Savani, say.
Sir, Eubacteria are modern bacteria because they have some special features than Archibacteria.
Very good. Very good. Correct answer. Now, except Savani, who can say Archibacteria is special bacteria, Eubacteria is not special bacteria? If Archibacteria is special, why it is having that speciality? What is
sir,
the main
because,
reason?
because they can live
because they can exist in harsh extreme areas like extremely salt areas like halophils, hot springs like thermoacidophils, and marshy areas like methanogens.
Very good. Absolutely perfect. Absolutely perfect. Now, if I ask you, Arachibacteria, maybe a specialty, whatever the you have said is the specialty. Now, how they are getting that specialty?
Because special cell structure and having different cell wall.
Very good. So, now this was the question which was asked in NEET examination also. So, you Arachibacteria differs from U bacteria because of the cell wall only. So, that is the most important. Right. Very good. Now, Khushi. Khushi only, no?
Yes, sir.
Question to you. You are ready to answer?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Now, my question is, if I ask you, what is bacteria? So, what will be your answer?
Bacteria are soul members of Monera.
Bacteria are soul members of Monera. Okay, correct. Your answer is correct. But it is not a candid answer. Candid answer.
Sir, can I say?
Please say the name who you want to say.
Ishwari.
No, not Ishwari and Sanika, Savani. Others from others I want to answer. Sambodhi, can you say?
Once again, repeat the question.
Sambodhi. You are able to hear? Yana?
Because they are unicellular prokaryotes.
Because they are unicellular prokaryotes. Right. 90% answer correct. Very good. Now, still anybody want to add this? If I ask you what is bacteria, what is one word answer?
So, may I?
Darshana?
Yes, sir.
Say Darshana.
So, it's a biological cell which consists of prokaryotic microorganisms.
Very good, correct. So, Yana also said correct only. You also said correct only. Any further answers?
Bacteria have simple internal structure.
Bacteria?
Have simple internal structure.
Okay, internal structure. Okay. Again, further.
So, bacteria are the organisms with simple cell structure but complex behavior.
Very good.
And they show extensive metabolic diversity.
Right. So if I ask you, which animals are bacteria? Which organisms are bacteria? Yana and that girl, Darshana, said that only. But little, still I need some perfect answer. Correct they said.
They are microscopic living organisms which are unicellular and prokaryotes.
Right. So, we can simply say that what is bacteria? Bacteria is microscopic unicellular prokaryote. Clear? So, all said absolutely correct only. But I need perfection. So, all 90%, 99% your answers are correct. Very good. Now, the next question. Now, can you guess? Structure of bacteria is simple, but their behavior is complex. How you can say that a bacteria is having complex behavior?
Sir, can I tell?
Say.
Because bacteria are unicellular as they have simple structure and they are they have symbiotic relationships. Many bacteria show different behavior like symbiotic, saprophytic and etc.
Absolutely perfect. So that is only the reason we say that they have the complex behavior. Behavior means yahan pe ye samajhna hai ki wo kaisa behave karte hai, achha bura wo nahi hai. Behavior means different modes of activities. Most common reproduction in bacteria.
asexual reproduction.
Perfect. Most common reproduction in bacteria.
Asexual reproduction, binary fission.
Very good. Asexual reproduction, that is to say binary fission. Correct. So this is for today. So in Monday's class, we will continue further. Okay. So I hope you all understood. But still, if any confusion is there,